Everyone, looking into the plant cell is an absolutely fascinating adventure because there's so much there. And I'd like to call it the basic framework of life. It's because of the fact that that one cell contains so much. And you know what? To learn from it. Let's look at what it looks like. Plant cell is sort of square and sort of oval. It kind of fits this kind of pattern. And I'll start with the ribosomes right here. They're where you will find the RNA and proteins created. RNA is the messenger. It sends the message throughout the entire cell of what functions need to be done and just kind of gives it the identity it has. Then you have the endoplasmic reticulum, which is usually divided up into rough and smooth. The rough side is where ribosomes attach. Smooth side, there's no ribosomes attached. On the side where the rough side is usually where you find the proteins created. On the smooth side, it's mainly fatty acids. Now, further down, we see the nucleus. Nucleus is the heart of the cell. The nucleus has the nuclear envelope right here, which protects it from the cytoplasm here and the inside of the nucleus is right there, so there's a dividing wall right here, that's the envelope. And then there's a nuclear pore, which goes right in and out, which allows the fluids to go inside and out. It's like a transport right here. And then you have the nucleus. I hope you can handle that. Anyway, right about here, that's the heart of the nucleus. Okay? Well, next we look at the cell wall. The cell wall is the wall. It divides one cell from another. It's like the drawing line for the cell. This is where the cell ends right here. It's a cell wall. And then just inside it, you're going to find a cell membrane. Cell membrane is like a cushion. It's like the part where the cytoplasm comes near the end, right to the cell membrane just before the cell wall. All right? You following so far? I think you're out there still. Anyway. Here we got the plasmodesma. What is that? Well, believe it or not, cells need to communicate to each other because they're right next to each other. So the plasmodesma is like a line of communication. It's a cytoplasm that goes from right here to other cells to communicate. Okay? That's what it does. Not bad. That's how things flow. Okay? Now you keep on moving. Vesicle. What's a vesicle? Vesicle is kind of a area where there's some fluid. It's got a membrane around it, circular, and it's located inside the cell itself. Then you have Golgi body, Golgi body. Folks, I have never been able to pronounce the Golgi body. I just never have been able to pronounce the Golgi body. So anyway, you got the Golgi body. Then you have what's called the Golgi body is involving in transport, intracellular transport of different materials within the cell body. That's what the Golgi bodies do. They're an apparatus. They get things moving back and forth. The peroxisome is an area where the fatty acids are broken down. You notice how this structure is able to put together and create and also has a way of breaking things down too. Does both. Then you have the vacuole. The vacuole is it's like a big hole right here in the middle of the cell, has fluid in it. And it's got a membrane around it. It's right there. Cytoplasm is all right around here. And here's the vacuole. All right? Now, next you have the mitochondria. That's the engine. That's the respiratory. That's how it keeps things moving. All right? The mitochondria. It's right here. And it's the engine of the cell. Lysosome, it's the digestive system for the cell. It breaks things down. It gets rid of stuff. And it's makes things go smoothly. And the cytoplasm? Well, the cytoplasm is all this fluid inside.
that keeps the body, keeps that cell moving around. And here's what's interesting. All these organelles that I've mentioned are in that cytoplasm. It's like a protoplasm that's inside the cell wall. All right. Now I say the best for last. Are you ready? Chloroplast, right here. What's that for? It's for that beautiful process called photosynthesis, where the sunlight comes down on that chloroplast and a chemical reaction takes place. So I put down 6CO2 plus 6CH2O plus light energy brings us C6H12O6. Let me say it again. 6CO2 plus CH2O plus light energy equals C6H12O6 plus 6O2. In other words, this reaction is what creates oxygen. That's right, folks. Photosynthesis happens as a result of the light coming down on the plant cell and landing on that chloroplast and allowing that chemical reaction to take place. Not bad, huh? Pretty cool stuff. And you thought it was going to be difficult. Well, I told you, I knew we could do it together. And now, folks, your teacher is on the way, ready to answer all your questions. See you later. Bye.